Now let's make our computer ready for PHP development. The very first thing we need to do is to install a local web server on our computer. Don't worry, it's super easy. There are many options, but I personally prefer Xampp. If you go to Google and search for Xampp, it would show you a website, apachefriends.org. You click on the link and it brings you to this page. Here you can download Xampp for Windows, Linux, or OS X. I'm using Windows, so I would choose this one, and then it would give me an installer. So here it has started to download Xampp for Windows. I'm going to cancel it because I have already downloaded it. After you download it, you click on the installation and it would run the installation for you. There is no special configuration that you need to do. Just keep everything to default and everything will be fine. The only thing that you need to choose is the folder that you want to install Xampp. By default in Windows it's C. I personally recommend you to keep it that way, but if you want to put it in another folder, no problem, you can do that as well. After the installation is completed, if you go to C, you can see that there is a folder called Xampp. Inside this, you can see all the files and folders that Xampp has installed on your computer. You can also search for Xampp control panel and it would bring me this window. In this window, you can see that there are many options: Apache, MySQL, FileZilla, Mercury, and Tomcat. But in our case, because we want to run PHP, we need Apache, so we click on start and it starts a local web server for us. Later, when we want to work with databases, we can use MySQL as well, but for now, it will create a local web server on port 80. We can close this. It will be running in the background. As you can see, there is a folder called htdocs. All the files we create should be inside this folder. As you can see, I have already created many folders, but when you come here, you might see nothing. You might see just a few folders and some default files. Now let's create our very first PHP file. Here in this case, I'm going to create a PHP course folder like this. And then inside this PHP course, I am going to create a new file, index.php. Now you can open it with Notepad, Notepad++, VS Code, PHP Storm, anything you want. In my case, I personally prefer PHP Storm for my PHP projects. It's very good and powerful. So I'm going to open this directory with PHP Storm. I double click on index.php so PHP Storm could open my file here. Now that our file is open, I can start writing PHP script. Any PHP script should be inside this PHP. Okay. And if you want to end it, you can end it like this. Any code outside this is not PHP. Any code before this is not PHP. But the codes inside this are considered as PHP. If the whole file is PHP and you do not have anything else, you can simply ignore this part and just have this opening code here. The very first thing that we want to do is to print hello world in our application. In PHP, you can use print or you can use echo. Echo is faster and we are going to use echo a lot. Echo can be used with parentheses or without parentheses. So if I want to say hello world, a string in PHP should be inside a double quote or single quote. Let's say hello world. We need to end the line with semicolon, otherwise we will get an error. As I said, I could use echo like this or I could put it in a parentheses. Both of them work fine, no problem. So I'm going to keep the one without parentheses. Now, if we go to our browser, if I go to localhost, this is the default page that Xampp is going to show me. This is the dashboard that Xampp has created. There are like how-to guides and PHP info. But as you remember, we have created a PHP course folder. The folder inside htdocs will be considered our root directory, and then when we create a folder inside that, we need to specify it in our URL path. So since we have created a folder called PHP course, our files would be in PHP course, and then we had index.php. If I run it, as you can see, we got hello world. Congratulations, you have just created your very first PHP application. Now let me explain some of the basics before we get started with the variables and data types and everything else. The very first thing that you need to know, if the file name is index.php, even if you ignore it, even if you don't write it in the URL, the very first file that PHP is going to run is index.php. So even if I don't write anything here, PHP is going to run index.php and show me hello world. The next thing we need to know is how to run PHP files. There are three ways. The very first way is, as we have seen, we put all the files we have inside Xampp HD docs, and then we can access it from our browser. The second way is to use the terminal we have. In Windows, you can use cmd or PowerShell. In Linux, you can use terminal. This is a Windows terminal that PHP Storm is showing me. So here I can run any command that I can normally run in PowerShell. If I want to run PHP files, I can write PHP and then the file name, like php index.php, and it will run the code for me. If I'm going to use this method, then the file itself can be in any folder inside my computer. But it has limitation. It's very good for running scripts, PHP scripts, and during the course I'm going to use the terminal a lot. But when we want to accept requests on our website, it should be a web server, so like Xampp, or there is a built-in option with PHP, there is a built-in local server. If we want to use the PHP's built-in server, we can run PHP hyphen capital S, and we write localhost and colon, and then the port. For example, I want the local web server to run on port 1000. So when I run this, it's going to create a local web server on this path. So if I go to my browser and run localhost port 8000, I will be getting hello world. The folder I'm in would be considered as the root directory, so in our case I didn't need to go to the folder PHP course, and it would run the code like this. With this built-in server, we can put our files in any folders we want. It's unlike Xampp that we have to put everything in HD docs folder. We can have our folders in any place we want and then run this command. But if I had to choose between Xampp and the built-in web server, I would choose Xampp because it's more powerful and it has more functionalities. So during the course, I'd be running PHP in my terminal or with Xampp. Now that we have built our very first application and we learned how to run PHP in terminal and with local web server, let's get a start and learn this amazing and powerful language.